Hi, this is Russ Anderson with another new feature run-through for Synthize 2204. Today, I'm going to point out a few details about burn-ins, like the frame number in the corner of this shot. Synthize can burn frame numbers, timecode, or timestamps into the camera or perspective views while you're working in Synthize, or into your save sequence or preview movie output files. Burn-ins are helpful for quality control, whether it's for your own internal checking or for talking to external clients. The main burn-in controls are on the View menu. These settings control burn-ins throughout Synthize. You can find them on the right-click menus of the camera and perspective views also. Those affect all windows too. The initial settings for new Synthize scenes are set by preferences in the Image Input section. Let's take a look at the different modes. Right now, we're in basic frame number mode. If you look at the details, you'll see the shot starting at frame 0, though the images start at frame 326. We do not have match frame numbers turned on for this shot. We could simply bring up the shot settings and turn on match frames if we want it. But numbering from 0 can be more convenient when the frame numbers are large. If we want to see the full frame number even with match frames off, we can switch to force match frame, a best of both approach. Now you see the image frame numbers. I'll quickly mention timestamps, which are available from some movie types. It's a time in seconds, usually from the beginning of the shot. If you ask for a timestamp and there isn't one, Synthize will add it and indicate that with a plus sign. Now, on to timecode. With timecode selected, you'll see it if it's available. Otherwise, you'll get frame numbers. If the last colon is a semicolon, it is a drop frame coding, which seems very rarely used, even though it's nominally necessary. There's little point to showing timecode if we don't have timecode to show. At present, Synthize can read timecode from ProRes movies on Windows and Linux, or from movies from any codec on Mac OS. It can also read from ARRI, Blackmagic RAW, OpenEXR, and Red RAW files. There's a preference in the Red RAW section to control whether the absolute or edge timecode is used. As you start to render output, you'll work with the Save Sequence and Preview Movie panels. Both of them have a burn-in checkbox to turn it off or on temporarily while the output images are rendering. Thanks for watching, and please check out the other Synthize 2204 videos.